Hello everyone and welcome back to the DU EVS course. Today we'll be covering the fifth topic from chapter 2, that is ecosystem. We'll be focusing mainly on the types of ecosystem. So without any further ado, let's move forward to understanding the concepts. So after learning this chapter so far, we now have the comprehensive idea about what an ecosystem really is. To sum it up, an ecosystem is a geographic area where animals, plants, and other organisms work together to form a life cycle. Now there are two types of ecosystem, the first one being terrestrial ecosystem and the second one being aquatic ecosystem. In this video, we'll be learning in detail about these two types of ecosystems. Terrestrial ecosystem. As the name suggests, terrestrial ecosystems are land-based ecosystems that are distributed around various geographical regions. These are classified as forest ecosystem, grassland ecosystem, and desert ecosystem. Beginning with forest ecosystem, we know that forest consists of plant community that is predominantly determined by trees, shrubs, vines, and soil cover. However, the scope of forest ecosystem is a bit wider. It includes several plants, animals, and microorganisms that live in coordination with the abiotic conditions of the environment. Some types of forests that are found in India are northern conifers or needle leaf forest, temperate deciduous forest, and tropical deciduous forest. The second type of terrestrial ecosystem is grassland ecosystem. Grassland includes areas where rainfall is generally low or where soil depth and quality are poor. Low rainfall prevents large number of trees and shrubs from growing, but is enough to support grass cover growth during monsoons. A variety of grasses, herbs, and several species of insects, birds, and mammals have evolved to adapt to these wide open grass-covered areas. Temperate grasslands and savanna grasslands are some examples of the grassland ecosystem. The last type of terrestrial ecosystem is desert ecosystem. We know that deserts are associated with warm temperatures, have little rainfall, and the days here are warmer and the nights are colder. Desert and semi-arid areas are highly specialized and sensitive ecosystems that can be easily destroyed by human activities. Species in these areas can only live in this special habitat. The most typical desert landscape in India is in Rajasthan, that is in the Thar Desert. There are also areas covered with sparse grasses and some shrubs that grow when it rains. These areas are made up of thorny bushes and trees like kher and babool. Moving on to aquatic ecosystem. As the name suggests, in aquatic ecosystem, plants and animals live in water. These species are adapted to live in different types of aquatic habitats. The biotic peculiarities are the physical aspects such as the quality of water, which includes clarity, salinity, oxygen content, and flow rate. This consists of marine environments of the seas, lakes, rivers, ponds and wetlands. These can be further classified into freshwater ecosystem and marine ecosystem. The freshwater ecosystem is an aquatic ecosystem that includes rivers in running water and ponds, lakes and tanks where water does not flow. Marine ecosystems are highly saline areas including river deltas and oceans. Marine ecosystems have more substantial salt content and have greater biodiversity in comparison to the freshwater ecosystem. Marine ecosystems are highly saline, whereas brackish areas have less saline water than river deltas. Now, I hope that this chapter is absolutely clear. For detailed notes, visit our website hrcharitma.com. And if you have any doubts, please feel free to reach out to us through the comments.